I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in and follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, you're holding mine. Between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it, darling, you look my dreams. I hope that someday I'll share her home. I found a love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own.
Things divided into unity and established an unbroken bond between them, who blessed Isaac and Rebekah and made them heirs of your promise. Bless these your servants, guiding them in every good work. For you are a merciful and loving God, and to you we ascribe glory, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and to the ages of ages. Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
And let our hands into the Lord. To you, O Lord.
O Lord God, who have espoused the church as a pure virgin from among the nations, bless these rings and unite to preserve these your servants in peace and concord. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The servant of God, Nicholas, is betrothed to the handmaiden of God, Tara, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The servant of God, Nicholas, is betrothed to the handmaiden of God, Tara, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The servant of God, Nicholas, is betrothed to the handmaiden of God, Tara, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The servant of God, Tara, is betrothed to the servant of God, Nicholas, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The servant of God, Terah, is betrothed to the servant of God, Nicholas. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The servant of God, Terah, is betrothed to the servant of God, Nicholas. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. O Lord our God, who accompanied the servant of the patriarch Abraham to Mesopotamia, where he was sent to find a bride for his master Isaac, and through the watering at the well revealed to him that he should betroth Rebekah, bless the betrothal of your servants Nicholas and Terah, and confirm the promise they have given to each other. Fortify them with your divine unity. For you from the beginning created male and female, and by your will is woman joined to man for help and for the continuance of the human race. Yes, Lord our God, who sent your truth upon your inheritance and your promise upon your servants, our fathers, your chosen ones from generation to generation, look down upon your servants, Nicholas and Terah, strengthen their betrothal in faith and concord in truth and love. For it was you, Lord, who taught us to give our pledge through a ring and to remain faithful in everything. Through a ring, the authority was given to Joseph in Egypt. Through a ring, Daniel was glorified in the land of Babylon. Through a ring, the true identity of Tamar was discovered. Through a ring, our Heavenly Father showed mercy on the prodigal son. For he said, put a ring on his finger and bring the fatted calf and kill it so that we can eat and rejoice. Your right hand, O Lord, enabled Moses to cross the Red Sea. By your true word, the heavens were made firm and the earth was established, and the right hand of your servants shall be blessed by your mighty word and your upraised arm. Do you now, Master, bless this putting on of rings with a heavenly blessing, and may an angel of the Lord go before them all the days of their lives. For you are he who blesses and sanctifies all things, and to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and from for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, ever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. God knows of you, the maker of all creation. In your love for man, you transformed the rib of our forefather Adam into woman and blessed them and said, be fruitful and multiply and have dominion over the earth. And you made the two of them one member through union. For this reason shall man leave his father and mother and shall cleave to his own wife, and the two shall be one flesh.
And those whom God has yoked together, let no man separate. You blessed your servant Abraham by granting Sarah offspring and made him the father of many nations. You gave Isaac to Rebekah and blessed her child. You joined Jacob to Rachel and from him brought forth the 12 patriarchs. You united Joseph and Asenath and granted them Ephraim and Manasseh as offspring. You responded to Zacharias and Elizabeth and made their son the forerunner. From the root of Jesse he brought forth in the flesh the ever-virgin Mary, from whom you became incarnate and were born for the salvation of the human race. In your inexpressible grace and great goodness, you traveled to Cana of Galilee and blessed the wedding there, in order to show that the lawful union and the procreation of children from it are indeed your will. Do you, all holy Master, accept the prayer of us, your supplicants? And as you were there with them, be here also with us through your invisible presence. Bless this marriage and grant your servants, Nicholas and Tara, a tranquil life, long years, mature judgment, love for each other in the bond of peace, long-lasting prosperity, grace on their children, the crown of everlasting glory. Make them worthy to see their children's children, preserve their marital bed and Bible, and bestow upon them the dew of heaven from above and all the riches of the earth. Fill their home with wheat, wine, and oil, and with every good thing, so that they may give to those in need and grant to those here present all their requests that lead to salvation. For you are the God of mercy, compassion, and love, and to you we ascribe glory, together with the beginning of this Father and your all holy good and life creating Spirit, now and ever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Bless you, Lord our God. Celebrate the mystery of your marriage, lawgiver of the marriage of the body, guardian of incorruption, and righteous steward of the gifts of this life. In the beginning, O Master, you created man and established him as the king of creation and said, it is not good that man should be alone on the earth. Let us make a helper fit for him. And taking one of his ribs, you formed woman. And when Adam saw her, he said, this at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of her man. For this reason shall a man leave his father and mother and shall cleave to his own wife, and the two shall be one flesh. And those whom God has yoked together, let no man separate. Do you now, Lord and Master, our God, send down your heavenly grace upon your servants, Nicholas and Tara, and grant that this maiden may all things submit to the man and that this your servant may be the head of the woman so that they may live according to your will. Bless them, Lord our God, as you blessed Abraham and Sarah, Isaac and Rebekah, Jacob and all the patriarchs, Joseph and Asenath, Moses and Zipporah, Joachim and Anna, Zacharias and Elizabeth. Guard them, O Lord our God, as you guarded Noah in the ark, Jonah in the belly of the whale, and the three holy youths from the fire, by sending down upon them dew from heaven. And let there come upon them that great joy which the blessed Helena felt when she found the precious cross. Remember them, O Lord God, as you remember Enoch, Shem, and Elias, as you remembered your holy 40 martyrs, on whom you sent down crowns from heaven. Remember, O Lord our God, the parents who brought them up, for the blessings of parents make firm the foundations of homes. Remember, O Lord our God, your servants, the attendants, who have come together to share this rejoicing. Remember, O Lord our God, your servant Nicholas and your servant Tara, and bless them. Grant them the fruit of the womb, fair children, oneness of souls and bodies. Exalt them as the cedars of Lebanon, as a luxuriant vine, graciously give to them the fullness of blessings, so that being sufficient in everything, they may abound in every good work that is acceptable to you, and may see their children's children like newly planted olive trees round about their table. And having pleased you in every way, they may shine as the stars of heaven. In you, our Lord, to whom are due all glory, dominion, honor, and worship, now and ever into the ages of ages. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy God, who created man out of dust, and from his rib fashioned woman whom you joined to him as helper fit for him, For it seemed good to your majesty that man should not be alone on the earth. Do you now, O Master, stretch out your hand from your holy dwelling place and join your servants, Nicholas, and your servant, Terah. For by you is woman joined to man. Yoke them in oneness of mind. Crown them into one flesh. Grant them the fruit of the womb, the joy of fair children. For yours is the dominion, and yours is the kingdom and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. For the servant of God, Terah, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the servant of God, Nicholas, is crowned for the servant of God, Terah, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the servant of God, Nicholas, is crowned for the servant of God, Terah, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The servant of God, Terah, is crowned for the servant of God, Nicholas, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The servant of God, Terah, is crowned for the servant of God, Nicholas, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The servant of God, Terah, is crowned for the servant of God, Nicholas, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
But deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever to the ages of ages. Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, we are all things by your power. Establish the world,
This common covenant you offer to those who have been married, for your name is blessed, and your kingdom is glorified, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Okay, three little sips each, okay.
Be magnified, O bridegroom, like Abraham, and be blessed like Isaac, and multiply like Jacob, walking in peace and fulfilling in righteousness the commandments of God. And you, O bride, be glorified like Sarah, and be glad like Rebekah, and multiply like Rachel, rejoicing in your own husband and observing the requirements of the law, for so God is well pleased. Let us pray to the Lord. O God, our God, who went to Cana of Galilee and blessed the wedding there, bless also these your servants, who by your providence have been joined together in the community of matrimony. Bless their goings out and their comings in. Grant them a life full of all good things, and take up their crowns. Into your kingdom. And preserve them undefiled, blameless, and beyond reproach to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with all. Let us bow our heads unto the Lord. May the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the all holy and consubstantial and life creating Trinity, the one Godhead and kingdom, bless you and grant to you long life, beautiful children, progress in life and growth in faith. Enrich you with all the good things of the earth, and make you worthy to enjoy the blessings promised to us through the intercessions of the Holy Theotokos and of all the saints.
Amen.
Glory to you, our God, our hope, glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Holy Father, give them a blessing.
May Christ, our true God, who by his coming to Cana rendered marriage honorable, the intercessions of all pure,
Holy Mother of the Holy Glories, and all praise the apostles of the Holy God-bearing, rulers equal to the apostles Constantine and Helen, of the Holy Greek Order Procopios, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is a good God who loves mankind. Through the prayers of our Holy Fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
May the Trinity protect and keep you both and all of us always down to the ages and ages. Amen. Please be seated.
Just a little bit.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Nicholas and Tara are now joined together, as we heard many times in the prayers, in the bond of marriage, becoming one. Yes, it's good. You see that? And it is a blessing for me, for the church, for the parish, your parish in Houston, and for all who know and love you, to be here to celebrate with you on this beautiful and blessed day. I want to speak just a few moments about the scripture that we read from the Gospel of John, from the book of John, which is the well-known story of the wedding at Cana in Galilee. It was, as we heard, the first of his signs, our Lord's first miracle as he began his public ministry. And we know the story because we hear it all the time. He changed water into wine. It was water, and then they tasted again, and it was wine. Now, this is indeed a miracle. This is indeed a sign by our Lord, but it means something so much greater than just the fact that it was water before and it was wine afterwards. Because we learn so much from this that applies to our lives, and it will apply if you so respond to it in your life as you begin from this moment that the two unique individuals of Nicholas and Tara became one on this day, united as one, became one person in a mystical way, which is why we call these the mysteries of God that happens, because it's indeed by the grace of God that this happens. Yes, you're still Nicholas, and yes, you're still Tara, and you will always be that way. You both were created uniquely. There's no one else like the two of you. There's no one else like any one of us here, because we are created uniquely. But yet this mystery, the change from water to wine, the change from Nicholas and Tara as individuals to husband and wife today, was indeed a miracle. It was a sign that our Lord blessed you two with to become one. There's a couple of things here. First of all, we heard in this scripture that our Lord was invited to this wedding. He didn't crash this wedding. He didn't just show up. He was invited with his disciples to this wedding. You two, you are called to invite him to your wedding. You're called, more importantly, to invite him into your lives as you now begin your life together as husband and wife. This is what's signified by this three times around the table, because you noticed I was carrying and juggling a few things, and that is this book, this gospel, representing our Lord, the Word of God. Because indeed, when we travel in our journey of life together, you too, when you continue on in your journey now as husband and wife, you are called to invite the Lord into your life. Invite the Lord, bring him into your marriage and into your life together as you continue on in your journey throughout the remainder of your lives. That's number one. Number two, our Lord changed water into wine. How did the two of you become one? Indeed, it is a mystery, because our Lord is the one who changes you two as individuals into you two as one husband and wife now. And this is something that was amazing to the people that were there, but it is something that was not amazing to certainly her Lord and to his mother. Because you also heard in one of the prayers, the foundations of family. Family makes firm the foundations of your marriage. You two are here today because of the love and the care and the nurturing of your parents over the years. And so you two now have that calling to begin on this day to establish your own home. Not just a house, not just a place to live, but a home. A place where you two will now set the foundation, inviting our Lord as the cornerstone of that foundation for the rest of your lives. This is what happened today mystically. This is what happened today through divine love. And this is what happened today through the two of you who committed yourselves to each other from this day forward, even before this day, but ultimately from this day as husband and wife. So may our Lord continue to bless you, guide you, excuse me, and strengthen you all the days of your lives. You may now kiss your wife.
It's you, it's you, it's all for you. Everything I do, I tell you all the time. Heaven is a place on earth for you. Tell me all the things you wanna do. I heard that you like the bad girls, honey. Is that true? It's better than I ever even knew. They say that the world was built for two. Only worth living if somebody is loving you. Baby, now you do. Singing in the old bars, swinging with the old stars, living for the fame. Kissing in the blue dark, playing, pulling wild dots, video games. He holds me in his big arms, drunk and I am seeing stars. This is all I think of. Watching all our friends fall in and out of old clothes. This is my idea of fun, playing video games. It's you, it's you, it's all for you. Everything I do, I tell you all the time. Heaven is a place on earth with you. Tell me all the things you wanna do. I heard that you like the bad girls, honey. Is that true?
Well, I've seen you grow as a person, as a man. Whenever I first met Nick in ninth grade, we were both in choir, and he absolutely hated my guts, because I was stealing his best friend at the time. So we started at the bottom. It was rock bottom, and we had nowhere to go but up. And look where we are now. We're now best friends. thank you. And so, from there, our relationship grew, we became best friends. Whenever we went off to college, Nick was the only person I wanted to see whenever I came home. Family. And Nick became a brother to me. He is family to me. And there's nothing I would do to change him for the world. And then one day he calls me up. He says, "Hey Nick, I met this wonderful woman. I think you love her. I think you'd like to meet her." And lo and behold, whenever I got to meet her, everything he said about her was true. Not that I had any doubts by any means. And she was wonderful. She was beautiful. She was kind. I knew that she, from the moment I met her, that she would take care of Nick, and that she loved him. And that person was, of course, Tara. And so, from there, I've seen the relationship grow, I've seen change, and I'm excited to welcome Tara into my family as well. She was already there, but officially, marriage. And so I'm happy to welcome her to the family, because I know that she will take care of Nick, she will love Nick, and she'll kick his butt whenever he needs it. And with that, I'd like to raise a toast, Mr. and Mrs. Negron. Nicotero.
All right, guys, next up, a round of applause for our man, Laura Sarah.
Hi. I'm Sarah, for y'all that don't know me. Tara and I met about 15 years ago. I said, hi, I'm Sarah. She said, hi, I'm Tara. We went, oh my God, we rhyme. And apparently that's all it took to be best friends. And we've been pretty stuck together ever since. I've had to watch you grow into such an amazing, beautiful person. And I don't mean outside beauty, because you're just the most kind and caring woman that I know. And you've only grown more for having met Nick. I have loved watching the two of you together to figure out challenges together and overcome them. And I know that you're going to keep doing that together. So, cheers.
They cannot look at each other's answers. They can only hear our responses. So if I were to ask, who said I love you first? Oh, Nick, you sap. No, I'm kidding. All right, guys, here we go. Question number one, who spends more money? That was an easy one. Who is more organized? Looking a little one-sided for you, Nick. Who is more athletic? Who spends more time gaming? Who has spent more on League of Legends? Who is the better driver? Who is the night owl? Who is the morning person? Neither. I understand, I get that. Who is funnier? Who is more likely to get a traffic ticket? Who is more likely to be running late? Well, that's different. Who spends more time on their phone? The truth shall set you free, Tara. Who is more likely to apologize first? What? Okay. Who, did you also start the argument, though? Okay, I figured. I figured. Who would last longer on a desert island? I think we should test this theory. Who was the first to have a crush on the other? Oh, okay. Who takes longer showers? Who is more dramatic? Nick, what is happening, man? Who is more flexible? Now, we're going to have a conversation after this. Whose car is the cleanest? Who is more stubborn? Who hogs most of the bed? I can imagine those nights. Who holds their liquor better? Who is more of a nerd? Who is better at keeping surprises? All right, last question, maybe the hardest. Who do you love right now more than anyone else in the world? Aw, a round of applause for our newlyweds. Aw, seal it with a kiss. There you go. All right, guys. Now we are going to take one huge group photo. So we need every guest down to the floor. We're going to take one huge group photo.
thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Is he come? Is he go? Will you let me go?
Bismillah, no! We will not let you go.
Let him go!
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let him go!
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let
me go! We'll not let you go.
Let him go!
We'll not let you go.
Let me go!
No, 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 no!
Oh, Mamma Mia, Mamma Mia!
Mamma Mia, let me go! Beelzebub has the devil put aside for me.
Goodbye.
Thank you for everything.
Thank you so much for everything.
Good night. Congratulations.
Thank you.